All right, guys. So Joe Biden has went from snapping at the press to whispering at the press. Because that's essentially what he did at his press conference yesterday to discuss the new bipartisan infrastructure deal that the centrist senators have come through, right, with the Biden administration. Now, I must say, guys, before I play this clip, Biden is probably the most entertaining, boring president I've ever seen in my life. Okay, for a dude that's supposed to be a snores fest, the guy really is a meme, right? He's a meme at this point. Okay, and it's entertaining to me, okay, to watch this guy, because he's obviously losing it, right? He's losing his mind, okay? And it seems like this is happening almost on a daily basis at this point. But, you know, what's not funny is what the Democrats are doing, right? And their policies, okay? Because they're trying to artificially drive up wages and force them to do it by making businesses compete with the federal government. And this is something I've talked about before in depth, okay? And Biden essentially admits to that in this press conference. Take a look.
I got them $1.9 trillion relief so far. They're going to be getting checks in the mail that are consequential. I wrote the bill on the environment. We're going to increase more, and guess what? Remember, you're asking me, and I'm not being critical of y'all. I really mean this. It was legitimate questions you're asking me. Asking me, well, you know, guess what? Employers can't find workers. I said, yeah, pay them more. This is an employees bargaining chip now. What's happening? They're going to have to compete and start paying hardworking people a decent wage. And by the way, talk of inflation, the overwhelming consensus is going to pop up a little bit and then go back down. No one's talking about this great, great deal. So, again, if it turns out that what I've done so far, what we've done so far, is a mistake, it's going to show. It's going to show the economy's not going to grow like it wasn't before. People aren't going to have jobs with increased pay like it was before. People are going to be out of work like it was before with no options. Unemployment's going to continue to climb instead of continue to go down. If that happens, then my policies didn't make a lot of sense.
All right, so as you can see there, that's Biden whispering to the press, telling the press that, hey, guess what? Small businesses now have to compete with the government, okay? And in my opinion, guys, when I hear stuff like this, this is just another example of these corporate politicians screwing over small businesses, okay? And I'm just sick of this at this point. I'm sick of it. Because small businesses just can't, just pay them more. Just raise the wage. Just raise your wages, okay? That's what they say. This is how these Democrats think. This is how these leftists think. They think that the minimum wage can just be $25 an hour, $30 an hour. Ah, we just pay them whatever. Okay, as if money grows on trees. I mean, I don't know. Technically, it does. And when you got a money printer like Jerome Powell, right, has, then maybe it does. But that could affect the value of the money over time, right? It can make your money less valuable, which, you know, could, you know, lead to inflation. Which, speaking of inflation, Biden is essentially saying that, well, you know, inflation is going to go away. And he tries to say that there's a consensus on it. There's not actually a consensus on it. What he's actually referring to is Jerome Powell and Janet Yellen making an argument that they think that inflation is going to be transitory, right? That means that we're going to see a spike in inflation because during the beginning of the pandemic, we went through a deflationary period. Okay, and because the economy is opened back up, because the government has spent all this money, what's going to happen is that we're going to see prices spike again to compensate for what happened last year, right? That's the argument that's coming from the Fed, from Janet Yellen, from Jerome Powell, okay? And they think that over time, it's going to work itself out and it's going to smooth itself out and the rate of inflation is going to go back down. So up until this point, guys, we have seen inflation on the rise, right? We've seen the consumer price index go up. Just as the Fed said that it would. Now, the question is, how long will it last? That's the question. Okay? And Biden's trying to act like, well, we know that it's going to go away. And I would make the argument that, no, we don't know if it's going to go away. We don't know. Because we never spent this much money before. We've never been in this situation before. So to say that you know for sure that it's going to go away or go back down, hey, man, I got some questions. And this has always been my little conspiracy theory about the Democrats and their economic policy in regards to the pandemic, is that they're using this as an opportunity to create problems that we otherwise wouldn't have, to push for their democratic solutions, their big government solutions. Okay, that's why they were so slow to open back up schools. Well, if we don't open back up schools, then I guess people need more childcare. Guess what's a part of the infrastructure package, guys? More childcare, right? You know, oh, I guess if these businesses are competing with the federal government in regards to paying workers and wages, I guess businesses are going to have to raise the wage. We don't have to pass $15 minimum wage now, right? It's stuff like that it's subtle, but Biden just admitted that's what they're doing, right? That's the point. The whole point is to force businesses to raise their wage. And like I said at the beginning of this, small businesses may not be able to handle this as well as big corporations. Yes, Walmart can do it. Amazon can do it. These big corporate companies, yeah, they can do it. That's why some of these companies are getting on board with the minimum wage. Why? Because they know that, okay, well, if the government raises the minimum wage, we're big enough to where we can handle it. We can absorb the cost. Small mom and pop shops, small businesses, not so much, right? And essentially, this is just a continuation of big corporate America and politicians selling out the little guy. That's what it is. And that's what really frustrates me about these politicians. None of these guys are for small business owners. Small business owners get screwed over continuously. The Biden administration, like I told you before, has come to a $1 trillion infrastructure plan with the Republicans, right? The centrist Republicans. So this is a sign of some bipartisanship. Now, you know, generally speaking, I do support infrastructure. I think that Republicans should have done it under Trump. They missed the opportunity to do it under Trump, and now them doing it under Biden, again, it just shows how incompetent the leadership of the Republican Party is. Cough, cough, Mitch McConnell, right? For as smart as he is, he's really stupid sometimes when it comes to understanding, like, listen, attempt some layups, right? Try to make some layups, okay? You let the Democrats miss layups, but sometimes Republicans need to try to get some layups. Score some points, okay? Do something, right? You just can't try to be in the way of the Democrats all the time. Because, it doesn't work. And I think that's how Trump kind of changed the Republican Party in a sense. He actually tried to score some layups. But unfortunately, they couldn't get an infrastructure deal passed under Trump because McConnell didn't want it. So now all of a sudden, it's up to Biden, and now he's getting the credit for it. But maybe he's not, because the left is not satisfied with his deal. Okay, for a variety of reasons. The first reason is that, well, apparently the group of senators that negotiated this deal with Biden, they're not diverse enough. They're not diverse enough. They're all white. So therefore, that's bad, right? According to some people on the left. Like, they're literally saying there are no black people, right? Or people of color, whatever you want to call it, in a part of negotiations. So therefore, we don't like the deal. Right. They also don't like the fact that they cut a deal with the Republicans. They don't like the fact that it's bipartisan. They wanted to go either far left. And this is people from mainstream news saying this. Right. That's how far left the mainstream news has gotten. OK, that's how far left they got. And my response to that would be like, well, you know, here's the thing. If black lawmakers wanted to be a part of the negotiations, right. Cory Booker. OK, he's a senator. Right. You have some other people. Hey, they have the opportunity. He can be a part of it. He just chose not to. I mean, it's almost like, what do you want? Do you want to invite black lawmakers to come in? Oh, no, y'all come in and negotiate. No, that's not how stuff works. Whoever the black lawmakers are, they got to want to be a part of it. If they don't want to be a part of it, they're not interested in negotiations, then hey, I guess they won't be a part of it. But it's funny to me, because this group of bipartisan senators, you have women, you have somebody that's from the LGBTQ community who's also a woman, but yet they're still complaining. Why are they complaining? Because they're white, okay? So again, they don't really care about diversity unless it has so-called people of color involved, right? They don't care about the diversity of LGBTQ or women or any of that. No, no, no. It has to go even further than that, right? They can't be all white, right? But like I said, they really shouldn't be blaming them. They really should be looking at the black lawmakers, Cory Booker, Raphael Warnock, and say, why are you guys not actively trying to negotiate and be in on this deal? That's who they really should be going after. It's not these people's fault that they're the ones that want to come together and do this in a bipartisan way. It's not their fault. It's not their fault. But, you know, like I said, it is what it is. But yeah, two problems from the left, not diverse enough, and it is not far left enough for them. And the right also has some issues with this because Mitt Romney is a part of it, right? So anything Mitt Romney touches or Lisa Murkowski touches or anything, any politician that Trump doesn't like, a lot of people on the right are just like, we can't do it, right? We don't like it. Okay, so that's basically where we're at in politics. And you also want to know something else that's pretty funny about this. While Biden's outside taking credit for this, right? You know, Biden likes to get in on projects and assignments that he thinks he can win on, like I've been telling you guys, while Kamala takes a losing assignment. So while Biden's out here taking photos with the bipartisan senators about coming to agreement on this, you have Kamala in the background. Looking like, damn, I'm not getting any credit for this, boy. She looking sad. Look at her, man. She just looking sad. Bro, I started to feel bad for Kamala a little bit, man. She's just getting the shit into the stick on everything. You can just tell. This role is not going as well as she thought it would be. It's just not. But let's read a little bit more here about this infrastructure deal and some of the overall details to get an idea of what they have agreed to. President Biden and a group of 10 centrist senators agreed to a roughly $1 trillion infrastructure plan Thursday, securing a long-sought bipartisan deal that lawmakers in the White House will now attempt to shepherd through Congress alongside a broader package sought by Democrats. Mr. Biden and Democrat leaders said that advancing the deal on transportation, water, and broadband infrastructure will hinge on the passage of more elements of Mr. Biden's $4 trillion economic agenda. The two-track process sets up weeks of delegate negotiations to gather support for both the bipartisan plan and a separate Democratic proposal, a challenging task in the 50-minute Senate and the narrowly Democratic-controlled House. Okay, so my understanding of the strategy here, at least from the Democrats, is that when it comes to the physical infrastructure part of it, they're going to be willing to negotiate with Republicans to get that passed through Congress using regular order, right? That's what they want to do. So they'll cut a deal on that. But the other part of Biden's infrastructure package, the families plan, aka the non-infrastructure portion of it that they frame as infrastructure, they want to pass that through reconciliation, okay? And that presents an interesting situation for the Republicans because if I'm Mitch McConnell and I know that the Democrats are cutting a deal with us on a physical infrastructure, but they're just going to use reconciliation on the other part of it, then why will we agree to do anything at all, right? Which probably is Mitch McConnell's position, okay? Because Biden's not out of the woods yet. Yes, he has some bipartisan senators on board with this, but that don't mean that the rest of the party is going to get on board. They got to get 60 votes, okay? So that means they got to get at least 10 votes from Republicans to overcome the filibuster. However, the Democrats, because of how far left they are, who knows? They may not even agree to do this. Okay, so you might have some far left Democrats like Bernie, like Elizabeth Warren, and be like, nah, this don't go far enough. We might not agree. So there's no guarantee that this is going to get done, even though it is bipartisan. Again, it shows you where we are in politics and just how divided things actually are. Right. The polarization is absolutely incredible. It really is. Quote, what we agreed on today is what we could agree on. The physical infrastructure. There's no agreement on the rest, Mr. Biden said, who said he wouldn't sign a bipartisan deal into law until a bill containing the rest of his agenda also is on his desk. If this is the only one that comes to me, I'm not signing it. Yep. So, yeah, basically what he's saying is that I want both parts. I want the physical infrastructure and I want the families plan. And I got to get both. So the plan from the Democrats to get both, I believe, is to, again, negotiate with the Republicans and come to a deal with them on the physical infrastructure and then just use reconciliation for the rest of it. So we'll see how that goes. With $579 billion in spending above expected federal levels and a total of $973 billion in investment over 5 years and $1.2 trillion if continued over eight. The agreement will make new investments in the electric grid, transit roads, and bridges and other forms of infrastructure. The cost of the spending will be covered by repurposing existing federal funds, public-private partnerships, and revenue collected from enhanced enforcement at the Internal Revenue Service, according to a distributed list by the White House. And this is what I was afraid of, guys. This is what I was afraid of. The enhanced IRS. And you know how I said these politicians like to screw over small business owners? That's what they can all agree on. An enhanced IRS, that means more audits. That means more small business owners getting screwed over. And that provision in and of itself is probably why I am against this infrastructure package, right? You know, like, they want to add more power to the IRS, right? And they both can agree on that, okay? But they can't agree on cutting spending. Can't agree on that, right? They can't agree on ways to pay for it by cutting out some of the pork, cutting out some of the bloat of the federal government. Nah, they can't agree on that. But we can agree to collect more of your money, to take more of the American citizens' money. And people say, oh, Biden's not raising taxes on the middle class. He's not raising taxes on the poor. Bro, most of the people that IRS audit are people who make less money, not more money, right? So listen, like I said, this is the trick these politicians pull, right? So even when you get a bipartisan deal, the problem with bipartisanship is that it's always corporate, okay? Just like what happened with the COVID relief package. You know who won based off that? Big corporate America. They won. Small businesses got screwed over. These politicians will always be bipartisan on what's best for big corporate America. I hope you guys are paying attention, right? This is what's happening. This is what they do. So, like I said, man, you know, I'm at a point of politics where I'm like, damn, you know, I don't agree with completely obstructing stuff, not doing anything. I also don't agree with the far left, but when you get bipartisan support on stuff, it always is corporate. Right. It always screws over the little guy. Right. And that's where, you know, I'm having issues. Right. When it comes to politics, it almost seems like, you know, there is no hope here to get anything that's going to benefit working class Americans. Right. You know, the small business owner. OK, that's what really bothers me. The list also includes sales from Strategic Petroleum Reserve and wireless spectrum auction sales, among the other revenue raisers. Emerging from the noontime meeting at the White House to announce the deal, Republicans and Democrats cast the agreement as proof that bipartisan progress is still possible in a polarized Washington. So, all right, there's no need to read the rest of that. You guys get the picture. So, yeah, Biden is essentially telling us that the unemployment is to force small business owners to raise their wages, right? To force businesses to raise their wages. And essentially, they've come to an infrastructure agreement that nobody really likes except those in the middle. So at this point, we'll see what happens moving forward. The question is, again, whether or not those on the far left and those on the right, are they going to actually agree with this, right? Are they going to actually be able to come together and say, you know what, yes, we should do it. And what changes will actually be made, if any, right? That's the question. And we'll see, right? But this seems to be Biden's really last hope to get something done, get some major legislation done during his administration. If he can't pull this off, if he can't get them to agree on this, they probably won't agree on anything. So let me know what you guys think. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Most importantly, share a Black conservative perspective. Peace.